What is going on, everyone? Welcome to today's video. If you're new here, my name's Ben Richardson. I am a personal trainer. I'm also a chemical engineer. And in today's video, I'm gonna talk about the best macronutrient ratio to boost testosterone levels. If you're new here, I want you to go ahead and subscribe to my channel because it's gonna teach you how to live a healthy, sustainable life through fitness, nutrition, and lifestyle decisions that you make in general so that you can boost your testosterone levels and feel like a freaking beast of a man. So if you haven't already, go ahead and subscribe and turn the notification bells on too so that you don't miss out on any of my latest content. Make sure you stick around for the whole video because when you use all the strategies and tactics that I'm going to show you in this video to use a optimal macronutrient split to boost your testosterone levels, you're going to get the best and the fastest results. So let's go ahead and dive in. So macronutrients isn't something that I really paid attention to when I first started losing weight. And it was a huge mistake on my part because the thing about optimal macronutrient ratio is that it is going to help you feel your best while you're losing weight and losing fat, which is ultimately going to boost your testosterone levels. It's very important that you still feel really good and are in optimal health, even while you're trying to lose weight and lose fat, because to lose fat, you're inevitably gonna have to send your body through some kind of stress. That's just part of the whole process in losing fat. You have to undergo some degree of stress in order to get rid of some of that belly fat. And that's exactly what we are trying to do by adhering to a proper macronutrient split. We want to feel good while we're losing fat, which is gonna help us boost our testosterone levels. And it's just gonna be this nice, good, positive feedback loop to just overall support great health. So let's talk about protein first. Protein is definitely a very important macronutrient group, but in my opinion, I think it is one of the most overhyped ones. And I kind of think that the fitness and nutrition industry is sort of catching on to protein being a very overhyped macronutrient. You don't need 200 plus grams of protein per day to make good results. My general recommendation is to try to get anywhere between 100 grams to 150 grams of protein per day. If you have a little bit more weight to lose or you're just a larger person in general, maybe you might need a little more, but very rarely does anyone ever need more than 200 grams of protein per day. So sticking to about 100 to 150, that's a pretty good general recommendation. Me personally, I mean, just for my size and my goals and stuff, I typically get about 130 to 140 grams of protein per day. Again, if you're a little bit on the bigger or larger side, maybe you need a little bit more. If you're a little bit smaller or you weigh less, you might be able to get away with doing less. But it's important to find that balance in protein. You need enough of it. I mean, 100 to 150 grams of protein might be a little bit more than what you're used to. It's important that you get enough of it, and it's gonna help you feel full, so it's gonna make losing fat a lot easier. But it's also important that you don't go overboard, because if you're eating 200 plus grams of protein per day, then that's taking away from a proper macronutrient ratio, because you're gonna need to eat a proper amount of carbohydrates and fats also. So let's go ahead and talk about carbohydrates. Now, carbohydrates have been demonized for a very long time. I think the trend in the fitness and nutrition industry is kind of getting away from demonization of carbohydrates and stuff. I think we're starting to realize the importance of carbs, but no matter what, I mean, one of the very first things that we talked about when I was in college, like I mentioned at the beginning of the video, I'm a chemical engineer and I had to take biochemistry courses in college. But one of the first things that we talked about in biochemistry when we talked about metabolic pathways is glucose metabolism. And that's because glucose metabolism is the preferred method for your body to use energy because it is extremely efficient, and that's what carbohydrate metabolism is. You want to fuel your body with enough carbohydrates because it's important in maintaining proper hormone balances, it's important in proper workout recovery, good sleep. Hormone regulation affects like every single area of how you feel throughout the day, what you experience, your mood, your energy levels, and you want your hormone hormones to always be optimized. And guess what? Testosterone is a hormone. So that does factor into everything. You want to be consuming a proper amount of carbohydrates. Now, I will say, I'd say it's a little bit more of a gray area as to what this should be. You can go as low as 35%. You can go as high as 55% if you want. I have even gone up to near 60%. And personally, I've experienced nothing but benefits going this high in carbohydrates. And I do think a good chunk of your carbohydrate content should come from natural fruits and whole fruits because they are just so jam-packed with so many nutrients. There are no disadvantages to eating more fruit. But things like starchy carbs, those are obviously going to be very filling and satiating. And that's important on the fat loss end of the equation. So make sure you're eating, you know, sweet potatoes or baked potatoes, red potatoes, whatever. Other starchy carbs like rice is good. Rice is very easily digestible. If you haven't checked out some of my other videos about good specific foods to eat, then I'd recommend that you check those out. Let me know what some of your favorite sources of carbohydrates are down in the comments below, just to give people kind of an idea of where to get them from. With carbohydrates, I'd say it's also good to just kind of pay attention to how you feel. So me personally, I feel really, really good and energetic going very high in carbohydrates, but not everyone's like me. We all have different bodies that function differently. Maybe you feel good going on the lower end of carbohydrates so that you can eat a little bit more fat in your diet, and that's fine. So feel free to experiment, but I'll just say this in terms of macronutrient split overall. The important thing is that you get a balance of all three macronutrients. You need a good amount of protein. You need enough of it, but not too much. Same with carbs. You need a solid amount of carbohydrates to support good health. You don't need a ridiculous amount, but you also need enough. And the same idea applies for fat as well. So let's go ahead and talk about fat. This is last but certainly not least because it is imperative to get enough fat in your diet, especially if you specifically want to support healthy testosterone levels. Because dietary fat is a straight up precursor in testosterone synthesis, so we want to be sure that we are properly fueling our body with enough fat. Fat is also going to play a key role in making sure you feel full and satisfied. So my general recommendation with fat is anywhere between 25 to 35% fats. But as far as some of my favorite sources of fats, I'm a huge fan of saturated fats and monounsaturated fats. I made a whole video about polyunsaturated fats and why they're just not good for your health. Feel free to check that out after you're done watching this video. But some of my favorite sources of fats are things like egg yolks, avocados, coconut oil, extra virgin olive oil. I also like getting some fats from things like good quality cheeses and stuff, good quality sour cream and dairy products. All of those are great sources of fats, so I definitely encourage you to try to get the bulk of your fats from sources like that. So again, with the proper macronutrient ratio, it's important to eat all three because carbs also go into hormone regulation and you feeling full and satisfied, but so do fats. So if you're not getting enough fats and you're eating too many carbs, that might be kind of an indication that you need to make an adjustment. In this whole process of going about paying attention to your macronutrient split in general, pay attention to how you feel. Pay attention to your hunger levels after you eat a meal, whether it's immediately after or like 30 minutes after. It's important to pay attention to how you're feeling to really dial in that really good macronutrient split for you. I'd try to base everything around your protein intake, because I'd say that's most important to stay in that good range of protein. So just to kind of recap with everything, eat anywhere between 100 to 150 grams per day. You don't have to be perfect. You know, you're not gonna get way better results if you zone into like 130, 140 per day. Just try to stick to a range. You know, don't overthink it. Don't overcomplicate it. But in terms of the best macronutrient split, I would encourage you to try out 30% protein, 45% carbs, and 25% fat. Try that just to start off if you have to make some adjustments along the way. anywhere in that range is good. The important takeaway is that you have a balance of all three. You don't want to do like 10% carbs, 40% protein, and I don't know, 50% fat or something like that, because that is putting a huge restriction on carbohydrates. Same with fat. You don't want to do like 5 or 10% fat and then 60 or 70% carbohydrates and 30 to 40% protein or something like that. That's restricting fat too much. So that's the key takeaway from the video. You need a balance of them. I would encourage you to try out 30% protein, 45% carbs, and 25% fat. That is what I personally am doing right now. I feel really good doing that. Everything is functioning on full throttle and stuff. And you know, I'm regularly getting stronger and improving in the gym. I sleep like a baby. I feel good throughout the day. So give that a shot. Pay attention to how you feel and make adjustments accordingly. And you'll be boosting your testosterone levels in no time flat. If you like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. And again, if you're new here, I want you to subscribe to my channel, because I'm going to be posting videos like this every single week, talking about things that you can do with your nutrition, your fitness regime, and lifestyle decisions that you make in general, so you can boost your testosterone and feel like a freaking beast of a man and be nice and healthy. So go ahead and subscribe if you haven't already. Let me know what you thought about the video in the comments down below. I always like to engage with you guys and see what your thoughts are and stuff and get some feedback on the content. If you made it to the end of the video, thanks a lot for sticking around. I hope you got a lot out of this. Take care, everyone, and I'll see you in the next video.